Friends, it's the Freedom Fairy. Welcome back to my channel. So it's been a hot minute since I've done a clothing haul. Now, people, I have been going a little bit crazy with the clothing shopping. I will be honest with you. I haven't shown any hauls just because stuff is still coming to me. And also I've gotten a few things here and there, and I just kind of thought, you know, either I'll do a collective haul or I'll do a lookbook. So let me know down below, what do you guys prefer to see from me? If you prefer to see a haul or if you prefer to see a lookbook. I kind of like to do all of them. All that stuff, just because I really like clothes. But the thing is, okay, so blah, blah, blah. So what is happening right now, you guys probably have seen on my Instagram, and I've talked a lot on this channel about my Saturn's return, about me stepping into a new career. And I just feel like, especially with this energy this month, with the eclipses and all the Mercury retrograde, among many other retrogrades we're having. Plus, this is my season, Cancer season. I mean, you know, and it's just a whole thing. It is a whole thing. But anyways, I have been eyeing some pieces of clothing from the brand Miracle Eye, and I first found out about them through Daisy LA, which, if you guys don't know, I am an ambassador for, and I'll link some of my videos I've done with the Daisy LA clothing before, and you can always find the link in my description box to shop their clothes and use my discount code. Which is still the Beagle Queen. I'm thinking maybe I have to change it because I'm no longer the Beagle Queen. I am the Freedom Fairy. But anyways, so they carry some other slow fashion brands, also run by women, in a section of their website called Daisy Lady Shop. And I had never bought anything from that section of the website before. Honestly, part of it is because my ambassador discount code doesn't work on those items, and the other part is I don't get commission from those items. So even though I thought they were cute, and also too, I will be honest, there's been some cute stuff, but it's just never been so cute that, oh, I have to have it, you know? But I guess it was a few months ago, I saw that they had a few things from Miracle Eye, and I started to get into Miracle Eye, started to follow them, and then I started to watch Devin Crimson on YouTube, which, if you guys don't follow her and you're into the 60s, 70s vibe, style, music, hair, makeup, follow her because she's like the queen, and she's just like embodying all, everything that I was always obsessed with. Like, that's what her channel is about. So it's cool to see, because we've seen, you guys will probably agree, we've seen many pinup YouTubers. There's a million of them now. and honestly, I like pinup, you know, I do. I definitely had a more pinup phase. I still like it, you know. P.S. I also bought some things from Vixen by Micheline Pitt. That will be in another video. But yeah, it's just cool to see that that now there's starting to become a larger community of people who like the fashion style that I've always been obsessed with. And there's companies like Miracle Eye who that's all that they sell, you know? And so what made me finally commit to a purchase or two. First was a few weeks ago, Danny, the business owner of Daisy LA, she got really real on her Instagram, and she expressed that, you know, their sales haven't been doing as well just because of the Instagram algorithm. And you guys know, if you guys are any type of influencer or someone who uses social media for their business, you guys know that every time that, you know, different things come up, different changes, updates come up in all these different apps and stuff, it kind of hurts us. It does. And you know, that's why it's also important to have alternative ways of marketing and getting yourself out there. But anyways, so the Daisy LA company has been hit pretty hard by that algorithm, and she expressed that they started to have to sell wholesale, and because of that, they had to increase their prices, and she hasn't been able to pay herself in a few months. And you know, me being a business owner myself and on the rise, and becoming more and more concerned with you know, the way that the fashion industry impacts the environment, on top of me already being obsessed with Miracle Eye, I was like, you know what, I'm gonna make a purchase. And so I bought a few things from the Daisy Lady shop, and a few of the things were from Miracle Eye, so that was the first thing. And then maybe like the next week or something, you know, something in my head, I kept on getting intuitive hits about Micheline Pitt and her brand, Vixen. And then I also kept on getting intuitive hits about Miracle Eye. And so I just went on YouTube because I was like, man, because if you guys are intuitive, or, you know, you just understand what I'm saying when you get intuitive hits, is like, you keep on, stuff in your life keeps on coming up. It's like a sign, you feel me? So many signs. That's why I say, when I say intuitive hits, like so many signs, so many signs, so many signs. And so I was like, okay, whatever. And I was like, let me just cool out all these signs, man. And so I went on YouTube, and I did some research on both Micheline and the founder of Miracle Eye, which is Larissa. And I watched their stories. They both had their stories online, like, you know, where they came from, how their brand happened. And both of their stories really, like, grabbed my heart, is the best way I can say it. And I mean, I have been following Micheline Pitt for a long time, very long time. I've been a fan of her, you know, her beauty and her clothing, you know, always been a fan, but I didn't know beyond that. I didn't know anything about her. And it was just very cool to hear her story. And also the founder of Miracle Eye, I had no idea. She's like younger than me. And you know, she went through a lot of similar struggles as me, and I literally cried. I literally cried when I watched her story. And I was like, you know what? It's happening. It's happening right now. I want to support these women. I do. And it's not, you know, and it's not just their clothes are cute, because that's enough, you know, that's enough. You like their clothes, okay, that's enough for me to follow them, to be a fan, you know. But on top of that, they created a successful business for themselves. Not only that, to hear where they came from, that was just so inspiring to me, thinking about my journey and what I'm trying to create. And you know, and I really want to support people that I am a fan of their work, and I'm inspired by their story. So Plus, I mean, the future is female, so so I wanna support female business owners. So that's how the second order came, and how Miracle Eye creates their clothing is it's made to order. So that's part of the slow fashion concept. Is like they don't have a whole bunch of clothing items already ready to go. It's you know, that's why it takes a little bit more time, because they make the clothes as they get the orders. So it was really cool for me to see kind of behind the scenes from Larissa's story that she shared. I'll link that video down below. And also, you know, I've been watching her stories on Instagram, and every time, you know, she's saying, okay, she has a stack of clothes and she's like, these are gonna go ship out tomorrow. And I'm like, those are my clothes. Those are the ones that I ordered. And of course, I could have picked out many more clothing items. There's just so many cute things on their website. They also have a vintage on there. And something really cool that I just found out, that she has a brick and mortar store where you can go and visit. But the thing is, you have to make an appointment. And I definitely want to do that at some point. And anyways, blah, 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 blah. Here we go. So, the first order that came to me was actually the one that it came a day before the other one, was the one that I ordered directly from Miracle Eye. And now when you order from the Daisy Lady shop, Daisy LA doesn't have those items in their warehouse. So what happens is you order from their website, but the individual companies of the Daisy Lady shop ship them from wherever they are. So it takes a little bit longer, I think. It's only one day longer, but again, I told you, I ordered from Daisy LA a week or so before I ordered from Miracle Eye, and Miracle Eye still came first. So just to let you know. And I loved how Miracle Eye sent and packaged their items. They sent it in a plastic mailer bag, and they put one of their stickers on there, their logo, which I thought was very cute. And now something that I am becoming more aware of is packaging and presentation and attention to detail. Just going through my own branding process with a branding consultant and animators and you know, logo design and all that stuff. I really appreciate the attention to detail. And also, I just like things that are cute. And then you open the mailer, and then the clothes are folded up nice and neat, and they're wrapped in brown paper very neatly. And they're tied with a very cute ribbon, an embroidered ribbon. And I plan to wear this in my hair, and maybe, I don't know, maybe I'll, I think it would be cute as a trim for some kind of jeans or something. I don't know. And then they also had this card on there that basically just says a little bit about their company, has their Instagram and their website. And again, some really cute artwork. They also put in the package that came from Miracle Eye, they also put a pin on the ribbon, and I will show it to you right now. I already attached it to my jean jacket that I have patches and pins on. So this is their logo, the eye. And I also like their name, Miracle Eye. I really like it. Just because after you hear their story, you know, it kind of makes sense. Plus, I really do believe in miracles and you know, eyes. You know, eye has a lot of symbolism, and I just like it. I just really, really like it. I like everything about this company, man. Okay, anyways. Can me and Larissa be best friends? Okay. Okay, so the first thing I actually got, I'm going to show you, is this overall shorts. I think they're called the sunrise or sunset overalls, but they are made out of vegan leather, and they are pretty comfortable. I mean, I kind of feel like it's been a while since I actually wore some kind of leather clothing, so I kind of forgot how leather is supposed to feel and all that, but I do like this material. It's pretty soft, it's pretty lightweight. I really love the pattern, the V pattern, and how it's like a regular side up V on the top and an upside down V on the bottom. And I think the cut of it is really cute and flattering, and the straps are adjustable. They don't unbuckle, but so it's a little bit tricky to put it on. I will just say that. And there's also a zip on the side to help you put it on and off. I didn't notice that throughout the day when I was wearing it today, it is July, and we actually have been kind of having a cooler summer in California. Climate change. Anyways, I didn't notice throughout the day that my legs were getting really sweaty. So I guess it is warmer than I thought it would be. Like when you feel it, it doesn't feel like it's thick. It feels lightweight. But I guess just the material, it just kind of retains a little bit of heat. So I guess you could wear this in colder weather even, and it wouldn't be such a big deal, even though it is shorts. And I just really, really like it. I really, really like it. And I was even doing yoga in them. And I think it's just super cute. And I just love it. Okay. And then the next thing I got from... So the overalls I got from Daisy LA, from the Daisy Lady Shop. And then other thing, kind of... Actually, and you know what? I saw these even last year on their website. I feel like I saw them even last year. So this might be an older design. I'm not sure, but they're very cute. Anyways, and then the one that really, really caught my eye was this I think it's called the Marigold jumpsuit. And now they have a few different cuts of it. So Miracle Eye did a collab with Daisy LA, and it's basically this long-sleeved pants jumpsuit. And the material is pretty stretchy, and it's this beautiful orange and yellow toned floral print, and it's just so cute. And the waist has some ruching and a little belt, and it does have some pockets, and it has a O-ring zipper. And I was dancing around in it last night when I tried it on, and it looks cool, honestly, if you have it zipped down low. And you know, you don't wear a bra, and you just see your little boobies, or big boobies if you have big ones. Or you could zip it up regular, you know. It's very, very cute. Oh, and plus, don't you just love the label? I'm obsessed with it. I'm just so, so obsessed with it. Such good quality material. A lot of their garments, I'm not sure if this is one of them, but a lot of their garments are actually made from dead stock. Vintage material, and that is part of why some of their items are more expensive. I mean, honestly, when you buy from a slow fashion company, that's just something you have to expect, is that it will cost more, but that's because they aren't using sweatshop labor. They're actually providing safe work conditions for the people that make the clothes. They are paying the seamstresses a fair wage. And that is something, again, like I said before, that is really kind of hitting more close to my heart, is paying people what they are worth. You know, part of that is charging my clients what I'm worth. And just thinking back to when I used to teach dance, of how much work went into that job and how difficult it was for me to survive on my own, as great as a gig as I did have, you know, being a dance teacher, working that many hours, with a boss that was very cool, is just kind of, it was just really depleting to me to be working so hard, but still, like, to the point of burnout and adrenal fatigue, and still have to ask my parents for help, you know? And I really want to be a part of a future that no matter what job people decide to take, that that job can sustain them, you know? And of course, different things, different jobs, and different levels of education and all that, of course, you know, people can make more than what they need to survive. Everybody, if we live on this earth, which requires us to make money so that we can buy food, so that we can have shelter, I think everybody should be paid enough for at least that. And so many people don't make enough for just even to get by. And so when I see that these beautiful clothes that I love do cost more, I'm not mad about the price. I'm just like, okay, well, either I need to work on my income so I can make more, and or I need to save, or, you know, there's some cool payment plans, Afterpay available. So that's pretty cool. Anyways, my second order, when I went on the Miracle Eye website, I chose these super cute bright blue jeans. They're a little bit high-waisted. They have a lace in the front, and then also this part is kind of like adjustable, you know what I mean? Because I will be honest, this is kind of how I am about online sizing. Even though they have size charts and all that, and if you measure yourself and, you know, you match up your measurements with the size chart, even then, sometimes it's not accurate. It's happened to me before where I've measured myself, matched it to the size chart, and when I got the item, it looked weird because it was, yeah, it fit, but it was a little bit too big, and it just looked weird. So I kind of just went, of course I measured myself, and I looked at the size chart, but if I were to match my measurements to the size chart, I think some items I would have been a size large, some items I would have been a size medium, you know? So I just kind of went with, Michelle, what size do you usually get? Just across the board, what's your general size range? Usually I'm good with the size small, no matter what company. Yeah, sometimes a size small is too big, sometimes a size small is too small. But because I saw that these jeans had this kind of thing, a drawstring, I was like, okay, it's gonna be more flexible with my waist measurement. And plus the material is stretchy, and it does have a side zip. So I ended up getting a size small in these jeans, and they actually have different lengths you could choose from. And I chose the 28 inseam, just cause like before, when I would buy pants online, I used to buy a lot of clothes from Delia's. The reels, remember? Delia's was the cool place to shop from in the early 2000s, in the 90s. I always got 28 inseam pants because I am more petite and I have shorter legs, and all the pants at the regular stores are way too long for me. So it's nice when they have that option of the different lengths. And they're just super cute and so vintagey. Of course, they're flared at the bottom, and I love this kind of bright blue, and they don't have any pockets on the back. It's just nice and smooth, and I'm so excited to wear these. Okay, if you guys follow me on Instagram, you guys know I was doing some polls about like which dress I should get for my birthday. And my birthday already passed. It was July 11th. Thank you to everyone who wished me a happy birthday. But I'm having a party at one of the dances that I go to. And I invited some of my friends, and we're gonna have some vegan snacks, and I custom ordered a cake from one of my friends, Amy at Hello Cake Girl. She makes great, great vegan pastries, and she can even make stuff without sugar if you ask her and pay her a little bit more. But anyways, so I wanted to wear, a special dress, a new dress. And I had my eye on a few different dresses, and at the end of the day, I couldn't decide. So I ended up getting two dresses that I could choose from. And if not, I could always wear the other dress another time. You know what I mean? So this was one of the dresses I wanted to get. And when I first saw it, I think I first saw it on the Miracle Eye Instagram. And then I also saw Devin Crimson. She sometimes does modeling for Miracle Eye, and she was modeling this dress in one of her vlogs, and it's just super, super cute. It's literally magic, man. It's made out of dead stock material from the 70s. It's called the Tiny Dancer dress, and I mean, hello, I am a dancer. Okay, I need this dress. Plus, if you guys also follow me on Instagram, there was, I need to tell you guys the whole story, but I'll just say it really quick.
One night I couldn't sleep, and I kept on having the images and the words of the moon, silver, the moon, silver, the moon, silver. Now, again, if you guys follow me and all that stuff, you guys know I am a Cancer. I am ruled by the moon. I identify on so many levels. And I have been working more with lunar energy, trying to learn more about it, trying to work with it, because it is my ruling planet, hello. Plus, if you're a female, more likely you tend to be ruled by the moon, because it is feminine energy, yin energy, artistic energy. Check, 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 that's all me. Plus, Sailor Moon, people, hello. Okay, anyways. So I got up because I was like, man, I keep on having this, the moon in my mind, and I was like, you know what, maybe I just need to read a little bit, go to the bathroom, drink some water, kind of like get this energy out, and then go back to sleep. So I was reading, a few pages in my astrology book, and then I just had the thing in my mind, oh, maybe I should automatic write. I haven't done that in a while. So I got out, I meditated, did my little writing, and the first goddess that I usually connect with is Goddess Maya, And I was asking her some questions, and I don't know how it really happened. I think I asked her, what message do you have for me? Or I asked her, does someone have a message for me? And she said, the moon. And I said, what? Okay, the moon. The moon has a message for me? I was like, what the heck? This is even a thing? I was like, all right. And I was freaking talking to the moon.
And so, I just thought I should share that story. Because this dress is silver. And it has these super cute, again, dead stock buttons on there. They're pearly. And I just love a dress with bell sleeves, and it's a mini dress. And it just feels, you would think that this fabric would be itchy because it has the sparkles. It's not itchy, it's actually very comfortable. And I'm obsessed with it. And I even thought I would wear this for my photo shoot for my business. But it didn't come in time, and plus my color palette didn't include silver. It actually included gold. So I don't know if it would have worked, but maybe for a different photo shoot I can wear it. Definitely. And then the last thing I got from Miracle Eye is this super beautiful, again, made out of dead stock lace from the 70s. It's a lace top, and it has daisies embroidered on it, and it's just really well made and designed. I like tops that have this ruffling around the collar and down the middle. I think they call it flower design or something, and it's also like ruffly kind of at the sleeves, and it again also has dead stock buttons from the 70s, and they're flower buttons, and I'm just so in love with all of the care that went into making these clothes, all the thought that went into it, and even down to the packaging. Are you serious? I'm just very obsessed with the company, and I definitely recommend, if you guys are interested in shopping from them, definitely go for it, you know? If you're in the LA area, I would love to have a private shopping session at their boutique, and I think that would just be so fun. Don't you think that would be so fun? But anyways, that's everything I got from Miracle Eye, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know down below what was your favorite item that I chose, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace, and also think differently.